This is the week ahead from Mark Nolan's podcast, looking at what will be making the news this week in Spain, the UK, Europe, and beyond. Remember to add this podcast to your favorite platform, and you can add us to your Alexa Flash briefing. Full details of how are on the website, marknolanspodcast.com. Here is Mark Nolan with the week ahead.
This is the week ahead, week beginning 4th of February 2024, and the week begins with the publication of December data on the trade balance in Germany, in a context in which the main economic economy is being weakened by the global logistics crisis and sluggish domestic demand. Subsequently, we'll know the data on the Purchasing Managers Index, the PMI, for the services sector in the Eurozone. In the UK, the PMI will also be published, which, unlike the Eurozone, was in expansionary territory in the last month. At the same time, the Centix Index and PPI of the Eurozone will be published the same day, together forming a good x-ray of the global development of the economy of the European continent. On Tuesday, the 6th, we'll know the evolution of factory orders in Germany and retail sales in the Eurozone. Wednesday, we'll know the data on industrial production in Germany, which will likely continue to show deterioration of the sector. In addition, data on industrial production in Spain and retail sales in Italy will be published. Finally, on Friday, we'll close the week with a publication of the CPI in Germany and industrial production in Italy. At the business level, the publication of results from the likes of Logistica, Una Caja, UBS, Carlsberg, Siemens, AstraZeneca and L'Oreal will be published. And on the global scale, the likes of Ford, Uber, PayPal, Disney, Philip Morris and PepsiCo will stand out. In the UK, Chancellor Jeremy Hunt is set to release an evaluation of its economic outlook on Monday. The update to November's gloomy forecast, which predicted meagre growth in the UK for the next 2 years and warned of persistently high inflation. And it's unlikely to make pleasant reading for the Treasury, given the OECD's recent assessment of the UK's economic prospects, added to which the economic stress of the next stage of Brexit. The OECD report is followed on Wednesday by the latest quarterly reviews from the Inspector NIESR think tank, which offered a similarly bleak outlook to the UK economy in November. Jeremy Hunt is busy again on Tuesday answering Treasury questions in a House of Commons, the same day that Michael Gove is in the Lords Committee session on Levelling Up, and Liz Truss is back in the limelight at the popular Conservatism launch event, all before the House of Commons rises for constituency recess on Thursday. And finally, almost finally, on Saturday is Chinese New Year, marking the year of the dragon, the fifth of the 12-year cycle of animals which appear in the Chinese zodiac. The year of the dragon is associated with the earthly branch symbol, which is pronounced Chen. And finally, Sunday the 11th of February is 11-2 in numerical terms, which is the annual day dedicated across Europe to those who serve in the emergency services, who help, guide and respond instantly when we dial those numbers on our telephone 112. Because the 11th of February is the Europe-wide recognition of 112 Day.
That was The Week Ahead from Mark Nolan's podcast. To be the first to find out what will be making the news headlines each week, search and subscribe to Mark Nolan's podcast on your favorite platform, including iTunes, Amazon, Alexa, and Spotify. From Mark Nolan and me, Lily, we'll see you next time.